and welcome to our first trick of the month. We're going to start with a very simple behaviour that most of your dogs probably already know, and that's a sit. We're going to start with a few things. So I have a clicker and a bowl of food, and I'm going to use that to lure Jasper into a sit. So what do I mean by luring? I'll have a piece of food in my hand, and I will use that hand with the food to put my dog into the position that I want him to be in. You'll find that most dogs will follow that food, and when their head goes up, their bum will automatically go down and they'll be in a sitting position. So we're going to start with luring with it in our hand. Once the dog is getting quite good at that, what we do is we take the lure out of our hand and we just have a plain hand, but we keep the same hand motion and position so that it almost looks like there's still food there. They will follow that hand signal and then feed from the other hand. And once they're fine with that, then we can switch on to proofing our sit, doing things like just asking with the hand signal or just asking with the... So to start with, you can use a clicker if you like. And when you are using a clicker or a marker word, those things are designed so that your dog knows that when you said that marker word or click that click, that particular instant in time was when they were doing what you wanted them to do. That's going to earn them the reward. Marker words are just as effective as clickers. So it's up to you which you use. For marker words, you may use yes or good, X, any word that you want to just use to assign as that is what I want you to do. Okay, so let's go ahead and we shall start. So I'm going to grab my food and get Jasper. Bring him up and sit. Good. So when I'm doing this, I'm actually saying the word sit at the same time as I'm luring, because sit, I'm fairly confident that that movement is going to get me my desired behaviour. So again, food in the hand, nose, and up. Once they're good at that, I'm still keeping the same movement, but without the food in my hand, I'm actually feeding from the other hand. Sit. I encourage all of you to video your training. Sit. Because it's very handy to pick up things that you don't quite see while you're actually doing the work. If you watch back your video, you'll see different things that can be improved or different things went really well. You might think it's a terrible session and then find that actually it was pretty good.